Street.
Uh-oh.
Say, Lieutenant, did you get that funny odor?
How could I miss it?
Oh, that'll be the morgue wagon now.
WGRF Buffalo 97 Rock.
War of the Worlds has had more of an impact on American culture than perhaps any other science fiction work in history. It has had a profound effect on the psyche of Americans, changing the way we look at science fiction, radio broadcasts, and even our place in the cosmos. Written in 1898 by H.G. Wells, it shocked the public. Here was a novel that removed man from the pinnacle of evolutionary progress. Earth was invaded by higher evolved beings from the planet Mars. Our attempts to defend against them was described as, quote, bows and arrows against lightning, end quote. In October 1938, the Columbia Radio Network broadcast a very realistic and dramatic radio version of War of the Worlds. Directing that Mercury Theater troupe in this production was a 24-year-old Orson Welles. The news-like narrative and few disclaimers created a total panic in many parts of the country. Police and emergency service phones were flooded by terrified callers. In 1968, a local version of War of the Worlds aired on WKBW radio and produced a similar result. So, why recreate something that's been done before? We present our version to pay tribute to that historic piece of radio and to give listeners today a terrifying taste of what it might have been like in 1938. We've updated the science, incorporated contemporary concepts, and reinforced the local aspect of this production to make it something that Buffalo listeners could identify with. Our goal, again, is to pay homage to a truly amazing creative effort, the original science fiction work of H.G. Wells. The War of the Worlds has stood the test of time and is an archetype for science fiction, radio broadcasts, and movies. As you listen tonight, you're going to experience what it might be like if the Niagara frontier was invaded by superior beings from another planet who wished our complete and total annihilation.
No one would have believed in the last years of the 20th century that this world was being watched keenly and closely by intelligence greater than man's and yet as mortal as his own, that as men busied themselves about their various concerns, they were scrutinized and studied perhaps almost as narrowly as a man with a microscope might scrutinize the transient creatures that swarm and multiply in a drop of water. With infinite complacency, men went to and fro over this globe about their affairs, serene in the assurance of their empire over matter. Yet intellects vast and cool and unsympathetic regarded this earth with envious eyes and slowly and surely drew their plans against us.
96.9, Buffalo's 97 Rock. Slick Daddy here with you on Halloween night, cranking out the tunage. And we've got Norton and Lederman. They're out at location, on location, I should say, at the 97 Rock Halloween party at Elio DiPaolo's, my favorite Italian joint. It's the Benefit Children's Hospital. And West, Anita's out and about tonight, too. We're going to be checking in with her down the road in a few minutes. I just saw this on the Internet. This is really freaky. I mean, I suppose it's perfect for Halloween, but apparently it's for real. NASA has confirmed. Yeah, funky NASA. NASA has confirmed that the Mars Observer space probe that has been in orbit around Mars since August of 97 has detected bright flashes on the planet's surface for nearly 6 weeks. Now, while NASA scientists have been unwilling to speculate on exactly the nature of these flashes, it's believed that they are sunlight reflecting off of rock formations. Now, how is that for weird? That's about as weird as it gets. Now, let's get on some more Zevon here. 97 Rock.
On location. Here's Larry Norton.
This is Larry Norton and Rob Lederman out here at the Children's Hospital Benefit at Elio DiPaolo's restaurant. And there's a lot going on out here, Rob.
Let me tell you something. The food is unbelievable, and the rumors are
that Jim Kelly should be showing up in a little while. Who knows? Meatloaf, I hear, may be showing up with him.
Yeah, of course, they've done some stuff together before, so that would be really cool. But I know for a fact right now we've got Ed Kilgore from Channel 2 is here, and Alex Van Pelt from the Buffalo Bills signing autographs. Also some former Buffalo Sabres, Larry Playfair and Derek Smith.
Plus there's $1,000 that we're going to be giving away for the costume contest at 11 o'clock tonight.
Right, now, if you want to come out, it goes until midnight. We'll probably do the judging for costumes for the best Halloween costume, probably a little before midnight. It's only $25 to get in the door, and all proceeds benefit Children's Hospital. Plus, the CPR band going on here soon, right?
Yes, the CPR. I think they're already setting up, so we're all set with that.
That's the same band that's out at the tailgate parties all the time with us for the Bills. So, live music from the CPR band, just $25 to get in, and it's all for a good cause for Children's Hospital. So, come on out to Ilio DiPaolo's Best Costume, $1,000 here from 97 Rock.
CCR Bad Moon Rising here on 97 Rocket. As I moon you, you couldn't tell if I was mooning. Your buddy Slickmeister here with a 15-song classic rock marathon coming up in, that's the beauty of radio, just a little while. And, you know, as I mentioned earlier, that weird story a few minutes ago, we were talking about those flashes on Mars. Well, NASA has issued an update on its report concerning the bright flashes on the surface of Mars. Information from orbiting unmanned space probe Mars Observer shows that the flashes are not reflections, light reflections, as reported earlier, but are actually explosions of some kind. We're going to have more details as they become available. We'll have somebody from our news department try to get in touch with the University of Buffalo. You talk to that, that astrophysicist Clay Forrester over there. Astrophysicist. He's going to get try to get his response to this whole strange bit of news that's going on from the planet Mars. Because if an astrophysicist doesn't know what the hell's going on, how are any of us supposed to know? Okay.
97 Rock, on location. Here's Anita West.
Yeah, we're out here. It's Anita West at the Muddy Taco. It's brand new in Batavia. And as we always say, come on down and say, hey. And we've got free balloons for the kids down here at the new Muddy Taco. And, of course, the reason why we are here, well, me personally anyway, is to sample the delicious-tasting Muddy Taco food. And it's really good about being down here is now I don't have to pay for it. It's free. Just call me a radio freebie person. My favorite here is the El Nino burrito. It's the biggest ever. It's completely huge here at the new Muddy Taco Batavia. And speaking of, well, huge, oh, I insulted him. It's the manager of the newest Muddy Taco here in Batavia. My buddy, because he gives me free food, it's Andy. How you doing, Andy?
Thanks, Anita. Yes, the El Nino is huge. We've got a couple people that can actually eat two or three of them, but that's another story. I hope you like the new Muddy Taco here. This is our newest one, and typical for Halloween, we've got lots of candy for the kids tonight. We've got some free balloons for everybody and free T-shirts to the first 50 people who come by and can sing us the Muddy Taco theme song.
Okay, so we're out here at the newest Muddy Taco location. We are in Batavia, and it was sort of worth the ride because I'm being turned on to all the free food. We're out here until 10 o'clock, so come on by and say hi. Once again, we've got the free balloons and all that for the kids, and come out and sing the Muddy Taco theme. It'll be fun. Okay? Back to 97 Rock. It's Anita West.
You're listening to a dramatization of H.G. Wells' War of the Worlds on 97 Rock. This is only a dramatization.
Let's go back to the phone. Hello, 97 Rock.
Hey, that Mars stuff sounds intense.
Isn't it, though?
Yes, it is.
Nothing like a little blinding light show on the planet Mars, eh?
Yeah.
Maybe it's a triumph reunion.
Can you play Space Truckin' for me, please?
I certainly could, sweetheart.
Oh, thanks, McDaddy.
Deep Purple from 97 Rock. 96.9, Buffalo's 97 Rock. All right, this is a bit unusual, but we're going to have to interrupt this tune for a special traffic bulletin.
Well, there's a traffic tie-up that's causing problems on the New York State Thruway near Exit 57 in Batavia. Early reports indicate a possible explosion near the thruway, and traffic is apparently at a standstill in both directions. Crews are on the scene. We've dispatched a traffic copter and should have a full report within minutes. This traffic report is brought to you by Healthcare Plan. Healthcare Plan is rated one of the 7 best HMOs in the United States for kids. Healthcare Plan, they put your health first. I'm Kristen Pekka, 97 Rock Traffic.
And your brother's McGunner, Slick Daddy. Listen, Christy Madison is here with a live call Christy?
I'm on with Dr. Clay Forrester, professor of astrophysics at UB. Doctor, everyone's been talking about these reported explosions on Mars. Just what's going on up there?
Well, we're certainly having some exciting and strange developments up there. As you probably know, for about nearly two months last summer, the Mars Observer space probe has been detecting enormous bursts of energy on the surface of Mars. We're not sure what could be causing these explosions at this time.
They are explosions, though, like bombs? I mean, are these explosions the work of little green men?
Well, explosions, yes, but no, not like bombs. We don't believe that they're purposeful. They're probably the result of a natural buildup of hydrogen gases powerful enough for objects to be hurled from the planet's surface, but completely natural. Not the work of little green men, I'm afraid.
Well,
although, I do note that these explosions occur in the Cydonia region of the planet Mars, where many people believe pyramids and a great face exist.
Really? Now, I want to go back to something you said. You said objects have been hurled off the planet's surface?
Yes, that's so. They're probably just large chunks of rock that are being thrown into orbit. I wouldn't worry about it, though. Actually, that's how we found these Martian meteors a few years ago that showed signs of life.
Well, that's absolutely incredible. Thank you very much, Doctor.
My pleasure.
Tom, back to you.
Okay, thanks, babe. Halloween nights, looked out of here with you, going back to the phones, and your request coming up in just a couple seconds. Don't touch it.
You're listening to a dramatization of H.G. Wells' War of the Worlds on 97 Rock. This is only a dramatization.
Yeah, 97 Rock, what's up?
Hey, Slick Daddy.
Yeah.
Hey, we lost power out here.
You what?
We lost power out here in Warsaw.
Get out of town. You're calling from Warsaw? You lost power? What happened? You forget to pay your bill, man?
No, man. We're like sitting in my buddy's basement, putting back a few cream ales and listening to you. And then a couple of minutes ago, everything went black. But we got a couple flashlights here, and a boom box is running on batteries, so we're still with you, Slick.
How's the cream ale, lads? It's still cold.
Hey, we're just drinking them faster.
Well, allow me to pour you one, pal, okay? One on the cuff, one on the arm, one on the house. All right?
Yeah. Hey, could you get on some Pat Travers for all us partying out here in the dark in Warsaw?
Yeah, I would say boom, boom, out go the lights would be appropriate. How's that sound?
You got it, Slick.
All right, we'll get this on Pat Travers for all the folks in the darkness tonight in Warsaw on 97 Rock. 97 Rock. All right, we're going to cut into this tune. I'm kind of tired of this song anyway. And we're going to go back out to Mighty Taco. Anita West is out there in Batavia. And I've never seen West freaking out like this. She's freaking out about something. Anita, what's going on out there?
Tom, can you hear me, man?
Yeah.
Tom?
Yeah, I hear you.
Well, there's a lot of static right here right now. You can't. It's Anita West. We were doing a remote at the Mighty Taco in Batavia. And about 15 minutes ago, as we're hanging out here, it just went white. It went white on us like daytime. It was as if someone turned on the sun. And this was followed by a loud, loud boom. And we all saw an enormous fireball fill the sky. It came down not very far from here, and a huge vacant field. I'm not sure about the direction. I believe it might be the New York Thruway. Excuse me, who are you?
My name is Miss.
Listen, is that the thruway we're looking at right over there, would you say?
I believe so, and I don't know what the hell's going on, but...
There was lights, the heat... I want to tell you something, Tom. The heat was... just to draw a really weird comparison, it's funny with how things happen and what you think about when something bad happens. But when I was at an Aerosmith concert in, like, the front row, they set off the fireworks. I was so close, I felt like they singed my eyelashes, my eyebrows. That's exactly what this reminded me of. It hit the ground, and it rumbled like an earthquake. And I've never been in one, but now I sort of feel like I was. The light all flickered. In fact, I'll be very frank. I'm surprised we're even on the air right now. There was a blast of hot air. It passed by us. It is the best way I can describe it. Tell me if you can hear me. We're getting this static thing now. Let's just keep going here. There is so much dust and dirt in the air right now. It is amazing. I got to tell you something. I'm a little flipped out here in Batavia. We can't really get a good look at where it came down again. I think it might be the New York Thruway, Tom.
Wow, this sounds really heavy. Anita, are you okay out there? Are you all right?
Are we all right? We're all right here at the remote. The engineers, I'm eyeballing everybody. You guys are. We're all right. I don't know how everything else is faring, Tom. Can't believe what's going on here right now. I think this orb thing came down in an empty field.
What?
Or It's landed on the thruway. I'm not really sure looking at the perspective. It's so huge, it could be both. I think it might be the thruway. This thing was huge. Tom, man, there's fires everywhere. It's very smoky. I see more grass fires than, you know, it's almost like watching those television newscasts of what goes on in California, and I'm watching it right now. It's very, very smoky. There's dust in the air. Tom, man, this is a bad scene out here, man, in Batavia.
I need it by chance. Did anyone have a video camera out there to catch this?
I'm sorry. You're cutting out again, Tom. Did anyone want
videotape it?
Videotape it? I don't think so. Tom, I really don't know. It's really become nuts out here. People are coming out of their houses. Some people are trying to get into their cars and take off. It's really crazy down here, Tom.
Carl,
there's
hold on.
Freaking coffee.
Anita, I've got Norton on the line.
God.
You hear me? Hello? Can you hear me?
Yeah, we're out at our Children's Hospital benefit, the Halloween party at Ilio DiPaolo's, and just about 2 minutes ago, the ground shook like an earthquake out here. The power went out. In fact, it's still out, and it's pretty chaotic out here. Have you heard anything there, Tom?
Well, Anita's out in Batavia, and about 15 minutes ago, a huge meteor or something of that nature slammed into the ground there. It's probably what you felt.
I don't think so. Like I said, this just happened, like, not more than 2 or 3 minutes ago. Wait, hang on. Okay. You know, hold on just 1 second.
You're talking to me? Yeah.
Listen, I can't confirm this, but people here are coming in and... Wait a second.
Yeah.
What? Where? Okay. All right, well... Yeah, listen, Tom, I'm sorry. This is really weird, but from what I can tell, some kind of huge object has come down here as well.
Well, they probably just saw with the one in Batavia that came down. It's got to be the same thing.
I don't think so. This just happened here. Wait a minute. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
I'm getting lots of static here.
Yeah. You there?
Okay.
Are you there, Larry?
Yes.
Okay.
All right, listen. It looks now like, I don't know, there's just static on the line here. Anyway, a huge fireball tore across the sky, and I'm being told it was a meteor, and it came down here like at the old Bethlehem steel plant. The power is still out here at this party, so we're working on putting all the equipment in the remote truck and in the van, and we're going to head out there with a wireless microphone and that and see if we can't tell you what's going on from there.
Well, if in fact that's true, then two huge meteors have now come down in Western New York tonight. How bizarre is this?
That's amazing. That would be big national news, wouldn't it?
Yeah. Now, is Lederman with you?
Of course not. He left his room with the lights went out. What?
All right, well, listen, call back if you get anything.
All right, Tom. All right. I'll let you know. I'll talk to you later.
Well, my hotline is ringing. Let's take this call. Maybe this will shed some light. Maybe we got some news here on the explosions. Yeah. Hello, 97 Rock Hotline.
Flick.
Yeah.
Hager.
Hey, what do you got for me?
Well, I don't have anything, but I'm coming in. I'm probably a few minutes away, but I wanted to get Christy to try and call that professor again and have her call over to Kevin O'Connell, too, and see if he's got anything. I was thinking maybe this thing is weather-related.
Well, she's back in the newsroom right now taking calls. The lines are jammed big time with cancellations and questions and whatnot.
Yeah, I've been actually trying to call, and I haven't been able to. Hold on, I got to make it a turn here.
Sure.
Yeah, I've been calling her, and I can't get through. That's why I'm calling her. Are you in a song right now?
No, we're live right now, as a matter of fact.
Oh, all right. Well, I've actually been making some calls, and I've got you turned down.
Yeah, I thought it might be somebody with some news for me.
Well, have Christy call O'Connell. Our deal with him is we can basically call any time for weather bulletins or whatever. And Bob Kuczynski's in doing the Sabres radio network for oldies. Let him know what's going on. I should be there in about a minute.
All right, that sounds good.
All right, later.
That was John Hager. He's the operations manager for 97 Rock and our sister stations, of course. Let's do this. I'll take a break, and we'll come right back and try and get this thing together if we can.
You're listening to a dramatization of H.G. Wells' War of the Worlds on 97 Rock. This is only a dramatization.
Tom, Christy's going to try and get O'Connell over, too. Hold on.
All right, we are trying to get a hold of Kevin O'Connell at Channel 2 and get an update on the...
Hello, Storm Center 2.
Kevin, it's Christy.
Hi, Christy.
Is there any news on these power outages? I mean, could they be weather-related?
Well, Christy, what we do know at this point is that apparently two enormous objects were picked up a little earlier tonight on our Doppler radar screen. And apparently they're not weather-related phenomenon. Our newsroom is saying most likely they might be meteors, but I'm afraid I really can't help you out much more than that. I'll update you as soon as I possibly can. This is definitely something that is very unusual.
Let's get traffic. We've got a traffic report, Tom.
All right, Kristen.
This is Kristen Pekka with a 97 Rock traffic update on the situation unfolding near Exit 57 on the New York State Thruway. Carl Russo is airborne with this live report.
Hey, listen, we're just about a mile from the Batavia exit, and as we approach, there's a line of cars in both directions. It looks like a parking lot down there. This is incredible. I don't know. They're not moving, but holy smokes!
What exactly do you see, Carl?
We're approaching some sort of fire or, well, there's a cloud of smoke. The chopper's going up with smoke. It's really tough to see here. It's starting to choke me. We better circle back, clear the air in this thing. If it was an explosion, it's still smoldering. I can't tell. Looking down here, I can't tell if it hit the thruway, but there's no way traffic can make it through. There's just way too much smoke. We're going to have to regroup, get back, get the smoke out of the cockpit here, and get back to you in a few minutes. Wow, unbelievable. This is Carl Russo with Airborne Traffic.
This traffic report is service of Ambisol Cold Sore Therapy. Ambisol Cold Sore Therapy, the only one with vitamin E and aloe, starts to relieve pain instantly. Ambisol Cold Sore Therapy uses directed, available at Walgreens. I'm Kristen Pekka, 97 Rock Traffic.
Okay, thanks, Kristen. We'll check back with you in a minute. As you might have expected, the phones are going berserk here at 97 Rock. Let me take a couple calls right now. Hello, 97 Rock.
Tom.
Yeah.
What's going on? We lost our power, and there's like this big thing across the lake.
Yeah, where are you calling from, bro?
I'm in Hamburg.
You're in Hamburg. Okay, no power in Hamburg, huh?
Well, no, it's back on now, but there's got to be a huge fire towards the lake, and the sky's like completely red.
Okay, man, just stay tuned to 97 Rock. We're not sure exactly what's good. A lot of bizarre things are happening. Just stay tuned. All right, pal.
All right, buddy.
Yeah, 97 Rock.
Well, I'm calling from Oakfield, you know, just north of Batavia.
Yeah.
Something happened, dude. I don't know what, but a big plane or something must have crashed over by the thruway.
Yeah, reports are it might be a meteor of some type.
A meteor?
I assume the power is still on in Oakfield.
No, as a matter of fact, it's off.
Really?
Me and my father-in-law kicked up the generator at our business here.
Okay, all right, Dave, thanks for the call. Thanks for the call, man. We got to go back to Christy.
All right. I have Dr. Forrester, professor of astrophysics at UB. And, sir, are you up to date on everything that's happened tonight?
From what I can gather, some of the information is a little sketchy right now. But it appears the two enormous meteorites have impacted in western New York. I got a page from the seismic people at UB, and they tell me that they've detected three separate shocks, however.
You mean three meteors have come down.
That's what it would seem to indicate, but we can only account for two objects at the time right now.
Well, are these meteors in any way related to the explosions on Mars that we talked about earlier?
Mars is at its closest proximity to Earth right now, but I'd really be guessing to say that these meteor impacts are the result of explosions on Mars. It's getting a bit out of control here. I'm going to have to go.
Wait, can we call you again then for an update later?
I think a news call from Channel 4 is going to be taking me out to Batavia to comment and hopefully view it, so perhaps later, yes.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Forrester. Slick Tom, we'll send it back to you. Anything new to report, and we'll check back.
Anita!
Yeah, okay.
Can you hear me? Hello?
Okay, let's take
Anita.
It.
Anita!
Okay.
Damn it.
What started out as
you
a remote
that,
at this new Muddy Taco in Batavia has really turned into something huge. Incredible. I don't know the words to actually describe this. What I can see from where I am, I'll tell you what, we're going to approach a little bit closer. From where I am, Tom, what I am seeing is a crater. I mean, I feel like I'm watching TV.
All right, well, good.
This crater has been growing bigger and bigger. I don't know how to describe this. We're going to move a little bit closer. I really know how to explain this, but the dirt, the ground is like evaporating around this thing, and it's as if you put a hot stove in the snow, okay? You dump a bucket of hot water in the snow. Where the dirt, Tom, this is beyond belief. Where it's going, I really don't know. The heat from this has started fires. The fire crews are like everywhere. A helicopter is overhead. There is a strange glow and a strange sound that we can from time to time hear. This is like surreal, man. Okay, I guess the roads here are being jammed with people trying to get a look at this thing. And right now they're asking everyone to stay off these roads so they can get the fire truck through, the necessary people that need to come through here to put out the grass fires. Once again, if you're thinking about getting on this road, the fire people, the police officers, the ambulances, they are asking everyone to please stay off these roads. And you keep it here. We'll try to hang in with you to try to give you reports. But please stay off the roads.
Okay, apparently that's Route 63, John.
Fire song.
Do I? No. Okay, all right. Here's Cream on 97 Rock. Breaking into this tune, we've got to go back out to Anita West right now, where strange things are going on near Batavia. Anita?
Tom, we are literally at the edge of this crater. I am literally as close as I really want to be. I'm going to put the microphone up to something. Can you hear that? Listen, listen. Is that coming across? Can you guys hear that? This thing is opening up out here. The top is coming off, and something is now moving inside this huge object. What's that? People are running away. Some are standing just staring at whatever this is. Can you hear that?
What?
I mean, I gotta put. It's a.
This is
amazing. In many ways, I don't even have words to describe what the hell is going on out
Anita,
here.
Anita, what's moving?
Through the smoke, we see things moving. It's hard to believe, but it looks like someone is there. There were definitely shapes moving near the bottom of this enormous crater. The crater has stopped growing. There's a strange clicking going on. Hold on, let's put the microphone out there. Can you hear it? There it is again. There they are. I don't know what I'm listening to. It's some kind of clicking. We just saw someone or something moved near the object, and now there is a strange green glow coming from the crater. I cannot believe what is going on here. I'm moving a little bit closer. I'm gonna put a. Let's get a white shirt on a stick and wave it like a flag. Tom, everyone understands a white flag.
Anita, just get out of there.
This is beyond anything you can ever imagine. I cannot believe. I am here for 97 Rock. I am 97 Rock, me, the crew here. We're one of the first on the scene here. But there's a guy right behind us. He's got a video camera going. And trust me, this is going to be worth a fortune to CNN or somebody. It's funny how you start thinking of stuff like that during this time. But thank God we've got the video camera. This is amazing. Keep the video going. Please keep the video camera going. Tom, we're getting close to the edge of the crater. Something is lifting out of the object. People are running away. No, keep the camera rolling. Please keep taping. It's a machine of some kind. It can't be something from this world. I got it.
Anita. Son of a. Anita. What the hell?
Are we going to the newsroom?
Yes, we are.
I got it.
Reagan is still here. Get him down here. Tell him we need him in the newsroom.
Hey, he's not here.
Yeah, tell him we need to.
In light of the startling developments that have taken place in Western New York here tonight, we will take it live now to keep you up to the minute on all developments that are taking place. Here is what we can report. Earlier tonight, at least two large objects of unknown origin have impacted in our community. One has crashed in Batavia, closing the eastbound lanes of the thruway. A second object came down about half an hour later and has crashed into the old Bethlehem steel plant. Now, we had broadcast remotes on the scene in Batavia, and we have lost all contact with both of them. At this point, we are unable to reestablish contact with our engineers in Batavia or Anita West. Okay, we are now going out to Larry Norton, who is at the Children's Hospital Halloween party in Blaisdell. Larry?
Yeah, Christy, the power is still out here, and it's kind of a surreal scene. I've got a wireless microphone from my remote truck. Lots of people have already left in kind of a hurry, but others are joking and hanging around trying to have a good time. As I said, the power is still off. We've got our generator going so we can broadcast. I can see this strange blue kind of white light off in the distance.
Bring
it's
it
over
in
the direction of the lake.
Okay, Larry. Larry, hold on. Bob Kaczynski is here. He's been handling updates for the Sabres radio network for the Leafs game tonight. And it sounds like something weird's happening at the arena.
Christy, about 10 minutes ago, there was a power outage at the Marine Midland Arena. We're trying to hook up with intermission host Tom Shue, and maybe...
Not ready yet.
Wait a minute. Okay, Tom, are you there? Tommy.
Bob, about 10 minutes ago, the entire Marine Midland Arena experienced a violent shaking. There was a Toronto power play in progress when the power went out here at Marine Midland Arena, and for about 5 minutes, the players were just left standing on the ice, wondering what was next. There was enough light from the backup generator for me to watch Matthew Barnaby skating around looking for his wife in the crowd. Bob, we're being asked to leave now, so we're going to pack up our equipment here. Everyone is being asked to leave.
Look at here, Bob, if you could do the update. Right down.
Empire Sports is also reporting power outages at several high school football games in the area. The Niagara Pioneer game has been canceled, and looks like we've got some other updates. Okay, let's send it to Tom Reagan.
To build a list of bulletins and cancellations off the faxes and internet, these are... as we get them in, they're in no particular order, so I'll try to speak as slowly and clearly as possible so we can get through them. First of all, third shift workers at Rich Products are asked not to report tonight. High school sporting events, including football, soccer, and cross country, have been postponed for tomorrow in Hamburg, Orchard Park, and Lakeshore. The Iroquois East Aurora football game tomorrow night is rescheduled until the end of the season. Huh?
Take this down.
This just in, all emergency and volunteer fire department employees in Hamburg have been asked to report to the respective divisions immediately. Let me repeat that. All emergency and volunteer fire department employees in Hamburg have been asked to report to the respective divisions immediately. The Western New York Red Cross is in need of volunteers to offer housing for residents whose homes have been damaged by these reported tremors or explosions. If you have available shelter, you're asked to call the Red Cross office in Lakeview. All military personnel, we are in a code blue, Shield 1 state. Now, we have reports that residents in Hamburg are asked...
Channel 2 is talking to a civil defense commander. Let's try and pick that up.
Hold the mic up to the set, please.
Right now, those reports are based entirely on hysteria and rumor. We can confirm that two large objects, most likely meteors, have impacted in western New York tonight. The first in Batavia, New York at 8:16 p.m. The second in Lackawanna, New York about 12 minutes later at 8:28 p.m. Now, there are sporadic power outages throughout western New York, and phone service is also out in Batavia. It appears at this time that the New York State Thruway has been closed in both directions near the Batavia exit. But for right now, we're advising caution. There could be more meteor impacts. Stay inside unless it's an emergency. We're in contact with National Civil Defense authorities, and we'll update you within the hour. But right now, I've got no further comment.
Bob, it's Rochester. Pick up
online. WHAM Newsroom.
Hi, it's Bob Kaczynski in Buffalo.
Hi, Bob. Jeff Kay here.
Hi, we're trying to get some details on this Batavia situation. Do you guys have anything?
Well, it was an explosion. You know, we heard it could be a meteor somewhere near the thruway. Got a reporter on the way, but we can't seem to get him up on his cell phone, and we tried paging him, but that's not working. And that's all we have now.
Have you had any power outages yet there in Rochester?
Well, as a matter of fact, we just got word that Pittsford and a good part of the west side of the city is out.
Anything we can do for you on this end?
Well, unless you could scare loose a steak and fries, you know.
Okay, we'll call you back for more updates.
Well, I think it's going to be a long night. We'll be here.
Okay. That was Jeff Kay, news director at WHAM in Rochester.
Okay, let's try and bring in Carl Russo in the traffic copter. Carl.
Okay, we're trying to get back above the crater near the thruway in Batavia. Smoke is cleared, traffic is still at a standstill, cars everywhere, and none of them moving. Looks like some people just abandoned their cars. It's a parking lot down there. What? Okay, my pal wants to swing around from the north, so we'll check back when we can see things a little better here.
Yes, it's over there.
Okay. All right, we called a diner in Batavia, which is what happened, and I got a woman who saw something. Hello?
Hello?
Are you there?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
You can hear me all right?
Uh-huh.
What happened exactly?
Oh, it was terrible. My husband and I and our friend had just left the restaurant, and we saw this light fly by and crash into the ground beyond some buildings.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
We thought it was a plane, but it was too bright.
Yeah. All right, so then what happened next after you saw it?
Well, my husband wanted to go look at it, but I was too afraid.
Yeah. That's all right. All right, listen, just take it easy. All right, so did you go?
No. I stayed at the diner, and he drove over with our friends, and that was almost an hour ago, and
yeah.
We haven't come back.
All right, calm down.
Everybody's leaving, and I don't know what's happening.
It's okay. Shh. All right. Just take it easy. Hello? Is she? Hello? Hello? Ma'am, come on, pick it up. Hello? She's not gonna pick the phone. Okay, so we still don't know what happened in Batavia. You obviously heard her story.
Where's Christy?
Christy left, John. Listen, you know, I can help you get some of these bulletins together, but somebody's got to help in engineering. I mean, I can't monitor all these feeds.
Dave, if you're listening, Dave Halleck, come to the station or send Joe in. Bob, could you report on some of these until I get Norton again?
Okay. As you can tell from what is going on out there tonight, folks, this is a night unlike any other in Buffalo's history, and events are happening so fast, we can barely keep up with them here in the newsroom. We're going to try. Now, we've switched here to the newsroom to keep you completely up to date with reports from all over West New York, and we will bring you updates from all of the news sources as we get them. We're just in contact with Larry Norton. I think he's at Apollo's, but we lost him. We're trying to get Larry Norton. Okay, great. Let's go to Larry Norton.
I don't know if you guys can hear me back there or not, but I got to tell you, nothing, I mean nothing, could have prepared us for what has happened here tonight. We left the Children's Hospital party about 20 minutes ago to come here. We're at the old Bethlehem Steel Plant, where an enormous object has crashed. There is smoke and there is dirt still hanging in the air. There's police and emergency vehicles everywhere. We tried to get closer to the craft, I guess we call it, but we were turned back by the authorities. I've got Steve Boyd here from Channel 7. Steve, maybe you were closer. Can you tell me, anybody have any idea what this is?
Well, Larry, when we first got to the scene, we thought this was a meteor, but as the lake winds continued blowing, it's becoming obvious this is not, I repeat, not a meteor in this enormous crater. This is somehow expanding. It's some form of huge metallic craft. You hear those strange clicking sounds that keep coming from it? It's enormous. But I spoke to some of the military and civil defense authorities who are out here on the scene, and they actually believe this may be a vehicle from another civilization, not of this world.
Wait, hold on, Steve. Somebody.
I saw, man.
What is that? Hold on. Somebody else is trying to say something here. What did you see? What is your name? Just calm down.
Anderson, I work security around
okay.
the plant. I
All
thought
right.
it was a plane.
Yeah.
So I saw my spotlight down in that crater, and then I saw them.
Well, what exactly did you see?
Oh, God, I don't know. They were horrible looking with leathery, wet skin and big, black, evil eyes, and they looked at me. They looked at me, and I couldn't move.
As unbelievable as that sounds, apparently this security guard was an eyewitness to a being or something from another world. The police are making us leave this area here right now, but Steve Boyd is going to stay on the scene with the Channel 7 News truck. We'll be able to hear what's going on from them. Panic is really starting here. I would not come to this area if you can. Somebody, if you can, please call my wife and tell her I'm on my way home.
Oh! I'll call her, Larry. Be careful out there. Okay. Wait a minute. I think we've got Tom Reagan. Tom, you got something?
Yeah, Bob.
Oh, man. You got headphones?
Throw them in. This is Laura Githens from the Buffalo News, and she came to the station when I'm taking you couldn't get to the news. What do you know? What happened?
You've been outside yet?
No. Well,
Let's
I mean, not I since this started.
It's unbelievable. What time is it? Oh, my God. I left house 2 hours ago. Okay, you haven't been outside?
No. I mean, I'm just getting reports in now, but, I mean, all we're getting is what we can see from Franklin Street.
Okay. God, I don't know where to start here. Okay.
You okay?
Right, no, I'm fine. It's just this is not Western New York like I know it to be when I grew up. This is nothing outside looks the way you're going to recognize it. Okay. All right. 2 hours ago, I got a call from my editor at home.
Uh-huh.
And she is calling. She said, we're calling everybody in. So whether you are local, city side, whether you are sports,
yeah.
lifestyle, copy clerk, get your ass in here now.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Say, right. So
we're trying to get people
big,
in now.
Right. And I'm thinking, you know, is this something like week and we got another shooting. No, so I try to get on the 219 and the radio is out, so I can't really hear that much. It's coming in, it's being in and out. And then I'm on the 219, I can't get near the city, so I go around and past the gallery. I get on the 33,
right?
Get off at Goodell, it starts getting crazy. I'm trying to come into the city. You looked outside?
Well, just
it's
from what
there.
We can
no,
say.
No, you can't. Delaware, Washington, gone. Pearl, gone. You can't get past them. You just can't get past them.
Past what?
Past the there's these. I would call them military vehicles. There's, I mean, you know military when you see it. It's, you know, the people in full dress,
yeah.
riot gear,
Have they blocked off the streets?
Yeah, you're not getting anywhere downtown. And I'm on the handheld, and I'm listening to you guys saying that the arena is being evacuated, right? So, hello, the news is next to the arena. So all the news staffers, unless they're out in the field, I would imagine that all my colleagues from the Buffalo News are in the field somewhere. But I can't get down there to log on, so I don't even know where everybody is. So I got to... I'm back to radio.
There you go. Well, you got the headphones on. You're okay. You're in your element. Well, we're not sure yet. Some of us who happen to be here tonight, we started getting bulletins and faxes, some sort of meteor crashes. Now, two of our remotes, we had a remote broadcast going before line, and this was in Batavia and Blaisdell. They experienced explosions. And some security guard told us, you know the way the news works, right? You're going to get little bits and pieces of information from everybody. Security guards, faxes.
Well, you get your best stuff.
I'm hoping we're not going to get some of it from the internet, for God's sakes, because then we won't believe any of it. But some security guard told us he saw some sort of creatures emerge at the Lackawanna site.
Come on.
I know. It's, you know. The local TV stations have crews and live reports that we're monitoring, but, you know, nothing's confirmed right now. So everybody's starting rumors, and you see the way it's...
John Hager's handing me this. This looks pretty legit. These are two reports off the wire, and I will just give you unedited what they say. Canadian defense officials are reporting that a large object has just hit the ground in southern Ontario. Now, how close to the border this is, I don't know. Large object believed at this time to be similar in nature to the objects that have come down in the western New York area. The exact location at this time unknown. Okay, first reports are indicating that this object has impacted. That's fancy talk for the object hit the lakeshore near Old Crystal Beach. It hit, so it, apparently there's something down near Old Crystal Beach.
Lori, listen, we're getting calls confirming that third object down in Canada now, but it's starting to become obvious that these are not meteors. And one of the latest reports we have right now is that some experts are calling in and voicing opinion that these objects are machines from another world.
Oh, okay, fine.
Yeah, I know. And one thing is for certain.
Tom, Bob's got a live one.
John, I've got Carol Jason from Channel 4 on the two-way radio right now. She's somewhere near Batavia, she tells me. WHE 805, Carol Jason. Come on in, Carol. Carol Jason. WHE 805 to Carol Jason. Carol, can you hear me, Carol?
Bob, can you hear me?
We've got you.
I really can't hear you too well, but let me just tell you what's going on. I am stuck in traffic. I can't get a call into Channel 4. The thruway is closed both directions. I mean, you can't move around here. It's like a used parking lot, used car lot. People they've left their cars, they're running. Some are walking, most are running. They're all going back towards Buffalo. And I can see a very strange glow in the distance. We don't know what it is. It looks like it might be coming from fires. And then there's a glow that's more like a blue-white color, and no one knows what that is. This is really, really serious. Not only can't move, but there has been just one military vehicle after another going towards Batavia on the shoulders of the freeway. They're passing us right now. They've got tanks. They've got troop carriers. They have all sorts of artillery pieces. Obviously, because the military has been called out big time. And whoa, all these planes now. Planes going overhead. We've got helicopters passing us now. I don't know what to make of all this. Dr. Forrester is with us. Thank goodness. He's from UB. But he doesn't know what's going on. But we are stuck in traffic. We can't go ahead. We don't know how to move out of here with all these planes going on over our heads. We are hearing reports, however, of a huge object. There's something that's in the air. A huge object. People say it's shaped like a triangle, just kind of hanging there, you know, hanging in the air. But this thing is so big, they say it's almost the size of a battleship. Oh, wait. We do see something now, way in the distance. It is moving slowly toward us. Unbelievable. Honestly, I've never seen anything like this. We're looking at it now. Doug Forster has binoculars. Oh, this is something. Bob, look, you got to call Postal. You got to tell him to call me on the two-way. My cell phone isn't working. You've got to get to Postal. Have him call me.
Get it in
Okay, Carol,
doctor.
Thanks.
Dr. Forrester.
Dr. Forrester with you, Carol. Can we talk to Dr. Forrester? Let's get more on this from the doctor. Dr. Forrester, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
What is the nature of the vehicle that you're seeing right now?
This is absolutely incredible. The aerial object is enormous. It's got to be, there's some means it's supporting itself by. It's an electromagnetic field or magnetic flux of some kind that's keeping the opposite poles of magnetism in perfect balance. It's the, that's got to be the only way that a craft of this size could support itself.
Now, reports from the other impact in Lackawanna talk about creatures from another world. Can you possibly agree with that?
I can only say that there's absolutely no doubt that what I'm viewing now is definitely a technology not from this planet. This is amazing. This thing, it's seeming to defy gravity. I wish we could get a closer look. This thing in the air has got to be the size of an aircraft carrier. It's enormous.
Now, based on our early reports, would you venture to say this is from Mars?
In fact, might be possible, but I'm guessing whatever this is certainly not from this planet. Right now, there's some kind of, I can see some sort of...
It's gone. Try him again.
Dr. Forrester.
Hold the button.
WHE-805 to Dr. Forrester.
Down.
Dr. Forrester.
Hold it down. No.
We've lost him.
You're listening to a dramatization of H.G. Wells' War of the Worlds on 97 Rock. This is only a dramatization.
All right, Laurie, if you could, why don't you just... I'm going to try and get Russo,
okay.
If you could just
what
read
this?
These.
Okay, and you're gonna try and get Carl?
Carl Russo?
You're going to try and get Carl? All right. Okay, we have reports now. Wow. Okay. We are getting reports now that are indicating that this is not a local event, all right? This is beyond the scope of Western New York. We have CNN reporting right now this hour that meteors have hit in Long Island. There have been two touching down in Virginia. Apparently, there's one in Quebec City. There are meteors. This is wild. There are meteors outside London. And we're apparently CNN is reporting out of Moscow that there are meteors down there. So obviously, this appears, as incredible as it seems, to be, do we want to say this is an invasion of creatures? I don't know, from something that's not in our world. I'm thinking like Independence Day here, except that this is real, and we're not home. All right, I'll keep reading here. Civil authorities are asking everyone to stay calm and to not leave their homes unless absolutely necessary. This is not local, so whether that makes you feel better or not, I don't know. This is happening all over the world, and... John, so what, we're going to try and get in touch with Carl Russo in the traffic copter to get, a better view of whatever we've got near Buffalo? Can you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Dave, bring him up on pod 3.
We'll try that. All right, Carl, what, we're going to try this in a couple minutes?
We do?
Okay. Russo?
I can see the thing. It's enormous. Even in the distance, it looks like a floating city block. Below me, there's miles of cars all in gridlock all along the thruway. Nobody's going anywhere. Military vehicles, they're lined up as far as I can see. They seem to be trying to contain this thing. It's just hanging there. Pull up, Bob! I can get closer to it now. The air was filled with military jets a few minutes ago. We're going in for a closer look. It's glowing brightly underneath. On top is a circular, looks like a moving telescope or pipe of some kind. Unlike anything I've ever seen. We're right up on it now. It's turning slightly in our direction. Oh, man!
Carl Russo.
Carl, come in. Come on back.
Hold on.
Come back.
Let me try it. Russo. Russo.
Carl, come back.
Carl,
come back.
Does this work? Russo.
Oh, God.
Try this. Hold on. Russo. Carl.
Tom's done.
Listen, I've got Don Postles on the line. Don,
yeah,
are you
Tom.
There?
Yeah, Tom.
First of all, Carol Jason's trying to reach you.
Yeah, we just got her on the two-way a few minutes ago, but cell phone and pager services have been zapped.
Yeah,
nothing's working.
That's what I've heard. All right, so first of all, what has Channel 4 reported up to this point?
Well, here's what we know right now.
Yeah.
Earlier tonight, two enormous objects crashed here in western New York.
Mm-hmm.
One in Batavia, the other in Lackawanna.
Right.
Reports also indicate a third object has crashed in southern Ontario.
Mm-hmm.
Now, reports from CBS and the Internet show that these objects have come down in numbers all across the planet. Details show these objects are spacecrafts of some kind. We have had reports, unconfirmed reports, though, of creatures, not of this earth, piloting these vehicles. So it started out as a typical late fall evening. It's turned into the greatest story of all time. News reports, Tom, are coming in so fast we can hardly keep up with it. We're trying desperately to separate fact from wild rumor.
Hold on. Now, we've just got a report from Carol Jason that people around the thruway area near Batavia, they're hearing loud explosions, much like gunfire, and big guns. These are big guns they're talking about. There's some bright flashes, reports of fires as well. Please be careful you're in that area. It's so difficult for us to keep up here with so many of the reports coming in. Many people, understandably, have already left our station here. They're leaving to go home to their families. I'm wondering about mine as well. It's so strange that reports from some parts of these cities are reporting literally nothing at all while chaos is breaking out all around us. Many so unaware of what's going on. Reality certainly is going to give them a check, a hard check, as soon as they figure out just what's going on. We're unable to establish any contact at all from Batavia. Similar reports from events now in Ontario near Crystal Beach and Shirkston. We've lost contact with so many people. The phones are apparently out, and we've lost contact with just about everybody. Wait.
We've
got Carol Jason back on the two-way. Okay, Carol, WHE 805 to Carol. Come in, Carol.
Tell you this, if you I did get a phone link up. I did get a hold of my assignment editor at the Buffalo News.
You did?
Yeah, I did. And it's as nuts there as it is here.
I can imagine.
And she told me that Erie County is now under martial law. All right? You remember Poland in the early 80s. Sorry. We have that in Buffalo now, martial law. So what this means for you is this, if you're out and about, no unauthorized vehicles are allowed on the thruway, the 190, the 290, or the Grand Island Bridge. Again, Erie County, under martial law, no unauthorized vehicles. That means your car or your four-wheeler, you are not on the thruway, the 190, the 290, or the Grand Island Bridge.
We've had blizzard experience with
this. Well, except that this is not blizzard. This is just some sort of panic. She was also told that we got somebody out by the Cheektowaga Bureau. They've had massive looting at the Galleria, which you can expect.
Mm-hmm.
You got fires going all over the area, whether by man or by these you know, touchdowns from these meteors. I don't know why. But I think the worst that they have right now, it's blanketing most of Broadway on the east side. So they've got crews out dealing with that. And we have some eyewitnesses who are saying, and this is rough, that there have been, you know, you're going to say probably a good handful, maybe a half dozen suicides off the Rainbow Bridge alone. They've just seen them, so we don't know who that is, but people are panicking, clearly, and they're going off the bridge. One man, apparently, again, this is just from what I got from one other reporter, saw one of these ships touching down out of the Lancaster ship, opened fire, took out two bystanders, including his teenage daughter. I got to take a break. I can't do this. I got to take a break. That's just, that's what we have right now.
We have an eyewitness. Bring it up, Bob. Line four.
Go ahead, caller.
Yeah, I didn't really, I lived about three miles from the thruway out there. For the past half hour, it was like World War III. I mean, constant pounding of guns. I couldn't really see anything, but it was like a pounding of guns, of explosions, machine gun fire, bright flashes everywhere, then nothing, not a sound. We got the hell out of there. This is nuts.
Where are you, caller?
Right now, I'm calling you from a payphone in Eden. I mean, there's people all over the roads. I mean, everybody that was in that area is heading out, heading south. I got to go.
Well, that was an eyewitness from Batavia. Now there's a lot of people fleeing that area. What else do we
Githens,
have?
Githens, all right.
Corey Githens again. You know, I don't know if you. I mean, to panic is kind of an understatement here. I mean, you know what we have here is this is bedlam. You know, if you're a lifer in Western New York, I don't know if we've ever seen this. We have traffic jammed in every direction out of the city. The Peace Bridge is locked. It's a lockup both ways, coming and going. If you're there, you're not going anywhere. People are abandoning their vehicles. They are on foot in both directions. The thruway is completely closed in both directions at the Batavia exit. The skyway is clogged. All the access roads south on the... What?
What?
Scanner
is confirmed that. 7 and 4 have it on.
Okay. Well, we're now getting a series of reports. This is unbelievable. We are now getting a series of reports.
I got nothing.
Who's independent? Who's confirmation?
4 and 7 have
it. All right. No, that's fine. We are getting independent confirmation from a variety of sources here, many of them eyewitnesses, that the military vehicles and the troops on the thruway have been completely wiped out by weapons of unknown origin. I don't want to say it's gunfire. I don't know if it's fire. They're wiped out. So, as you can hear, the situation, as you can hear in the background, and from what I'm being told, is a complete. It's a rout. The battle, if you want to call it that, is complete. We are completely engaged now. It's lasted less than 15 minutes, and then that's what. So they're all gone. They're all gone. Who we have?
Yeah, I'll take it.
Is it postals or Jenkins? Down
postals.
Again over at Channel 4. Okay. Go ahead.
Sources are telling us that these enormous vehicles that we're seeing here in Western New York are coming down in cities across the U.S. and around the world. The latest information we have says that these vehicles are believed to have come from the planet Mars. They are hostile, and so far, no attempt to stop them has been successful. Now, we don't have very much beyond that, because once these machines come out of their craters and start to move, no further contact is available in that area. Every report we get in here tonight is more fantastic than the one before. Our staffing is down, but we'll continue to track this the best we can. This invasion from Mars.
Civil defense, again, press conference.
Don't worry about Pat.
TV.
Just throw out
the city
right
of
Miami now.
As soon as possible. We know these Martian machines are working to some kind of plan. They come down in groups of three and are joined magnetically somehow, and then they link up. Once they do, they pulverize everything in the path. We have lost contact with our command post. People should be ready to evacuate on a moment's notice.
All right, Bob, if you would you take it, please? Just anything.
It has grown strangely quiet here. Most of the people who are staffing this newsroom have left. As you can imagine, they've left to try to find their families. I can't blame them. We can tell that the Martian machine from Batavia is on the outskirts of the city of Buffalo. Now, in the distance, we can see it from here. It is suspended in air. The size of this thing is enormous. We have phone calls that state the Martian machine in Canada can clearly be seen from this side of the border.
The Peace Bridge is out. We got a call. The bridge is gone.
Well, the Peace Bridge Authority now confirms that the Peace Bridge has been completely destroyed, apparently just moments ago.
People, you have to leave
okay.
Now. Forget your broadcast.
We are in a block of Buffalo that is being evacuated. Folks, if you are within the sound of my voice, I implore you, I beg you, please protect yourself and your family. Seek safety wherever that may be. Please seek shelter.
Guard carrier is just across the parking lot on Delaware.
We're just going to go to TV sound.
Gentlemen!
Okay.
You have 30 seconds to get out of this building!
All right, Dave. Dave's going to patch us onto a TV station. Anything that's still on the air, Dave. All right. That looks like Channel 7. Okay. There's Irv. Okay, let's pick up Irv Weinstein.
This is Irv Weinstein. I'm not sure if anyone can hear this transmission. I can't hear a thing in my headset, and it seems like I'm all alone out here. I've had no contact with the outside world for what seems like an eternity, but it's only been 5 minutes. I've just witnessed an incredible display of power from these Martian war machines. In a span of a few seconds, they destroyed the Peace Bridge and the Skyway with some form of heat ray. It's been pulverizing everything around here. I'm sorry, I'm out of breath. There were quite a few people here until about 20 minutes ago. They all scattered like mice or insects running from a man. It seems as if there's been a role reversal today. One gets the distinct impression that we are very quickly losing our hold on this planet. I have to keep my voice down. I'm literally right under one of the machines now. In the eye of the storm. It's huge. Silently gliding over this area. It's destroyed everything in its path. From where I am, I can see all three war machines. They're all within a few miles of each other. A moment ago, several police cars and other vehicles pulled up. People got out and began shooting at this enormous mechanism as it passed over. These men were extremely brave. One Martian machine released this oily black gas of some kind that fell and clung to the ground. It's expanding out in all directions, rolling like balloons. It's hard to describe. It must be highly poisonous. Anything it touches just shrivels and dies instantly. I'm out of breath from running. I'm practically cut off. I'm using a mobile uplink, and I have no idea if anyone is hearing this report. Hopefully it's being recorded back at the station. A record for future generations. If there are any. Oh. I'm sorry. I'm exhausted from running. All I can think of is how quickly this has all taken place. Today started out like any other day in Western New York. I woke up, chose a suit and tie for work. Thought about the Bills game this Sunday. When I heard the first report of a meteor impact, I thought that was the big story. None of us had any idea. In just a few hours, everything we ever knew would be destroyed. I can't believe how quickly we lost dominion over this planet. The one machine is... It's turning. Releasing more gas. The gas is maybe 100 yards from me. I've got to keep running. Running. I've got to keep running. I couldn't help thinking that we've done this exact thing ourselves. Exterminated members of our own species, less advanced cultures, and countless species of animals, all without mercy. They must have felt like we do now. I can barely talk. My mouth is so dry. I'm cut off from any hope of escape now. The ship has turned, and it's heading in my direction. There's no place left to run. I've got nowhere left to run. The gas is... It's maybe 20 yards from me, rolling slowly toward me like a black cloak. I'm leaning against a pile of concrete that earlier tonight supported the skyway. The gas is... It's just a few feet from me now. I'm through running. This thing is... It's slowly moving this way. Glowing. It looks evil and menacing. For me, I'm sorry. The battle ends. The battle ends here. And now...
Humanity was powerless against the terrible weapons and the super science of the invading Martians. The grid of civilization crashed quickly. Any remaining undamaged roads out of western New York were choked with hundreds of thousands of refugees, all fleeing for their lives. The rich and poor side by side, seeking refuge in the dense forests of the southern tier. The cold and dampness of a late fall in our region began to claim as many victims as the Martian heat ray. Everywhere, chaos and panic replaced the normal ebb and flow of daily life. With remarkable swiftness, the lives we once knew in this community came to an unimaginable end. Then, just when it truly seemed that mankind was about to lose its dominion over this earth forever, something miraculous happened. Everywhere, the enormous Martian war machines began to falter and crash from the sky. The end came quickly for them. Mars is a sterile world, completely free of bacteria of any kind. Their systems were ravaged by the many different forms of bacteria that we have long since evolved an immunity to. Once the Martians breathed our air, they were doomed. One Martian war machine crashed into the icy Niagara River. Another fell to earth in downtown Buffalo near Delaware and North Streets. And a third came to its final ironic resting place, one block from the Science Museum of Buffalo. In the end, when all that man had tried had failed, Earth was saved by the tiniest creatures that inhabit this planet. Nature, as it always has done, provided our ultimate salvation.
Thanks for waiting.
Go, go!
We now return you to 97 Rock.